When you hear, for example, a simple song like Pole Moose and you hear the lead guitar in that song, it can make you cry. It's beautiful in another level. I like people who do their thing, even if just plucking the lead guitar, just one string on the guitar. But you do it very well until it takes people places. Thank you, 5 minutes, for having me. I'm Eric Ngeno, Director of Specialized Writing and Messaging at State House here. Essentially, my job is just to write, to prepare the president's speeches, addresses, and special messages. I've been involved in writing, a bit of creative writing, analysis, essays, in the public domain. I wrote for Daily Nation, Sunday Nation actually, for very many years. For Nairobi Law Monthly, I still contribute to the Nairobi Law Monthly. And I began to get very involved in public discourse on various issues of national importance. I have worked very closely with the Deputy President for very many years, and that brought me in contact with the President. And I think when they were preparing the URP manifesto, and then afterwards when they merged into now the Jubilee coalition, when we are now preparing the harmonized manifesto for the party, then I think because we're working very closely with these people, they got to know me, they got to see how I message things, they got to see how I work with ideas and how I work with words. And I think they liked what they saw, and I began to prepare their addresses even during the campaign afterwards, and that's how I am here. That's how I ended up here. The most challenging part of writing the president's speech is capturing his mood. He is very specific on what he wants to be said, and sometimes you want to capture, you know, the way he has said it, and put it in the words that you that he would like to use. So him, he's a more tech charged sort of person, and he likes to hit the issues head on, and his mood usually comes out very, very clearly. And the best thing, I think the most loyal thing a speechwriter can do is to make sure that you project, you channel all that energy, the presidential energy as it were, into his speech. We just dress the message. That is it. Yeah, because even the style is his. He's very particular about expressions, about words. He's very particular about, you know, sometimes he says, hey, let's be respectful here. Sometimes he says, no. I didn't say that. I use my words carefully. You know, sometimes you want to moderate or you want to mediate. And he says, no, this is my speech. Your job is to channel it for me. Yeah, so essentially we just dress. We just dress. Days come in shapes and sizes, my friend. Like during Westgate, that was a very, very traumatic time. The president was personally affected by Westgate, and he was very, very, very sad. I mean, he was totally sad, even as president of Kenya, even before he knew that, I mean, his people were there. He was already shaken by this thing. He was very sad. We were all shocked and outraged. And here you have to prepare an address for the president. I've never felt pressure like that in my life. And you go and meet the president, and he was being strong. He was incredibly strong. He was incredibly strong. You're thinking, my God, this guy's family has been affected there. And I am already sad, even though I'm not directly affected, but I'm already so bereaved. And here he is, he's still commander-in-chief. He's still telling you what to tell Kenyans, you know? And he's still telling Kenyans, let's be strong, let's be united. The pressure of sympathy, the pressure of the shock of the attack itself, and the pressure of in fact that I had to do a speech very quickly. I have never felt pressure like that before. I have several favorite authors. And they have influenced the way I articulate, I message, I render ideas. If you read, say who now, John Le Carré, how do you say that in it sounds like a French word. He's like the Charles Dickens of the 21st century. He uses language beautifully. He uses language beautifully like a poem. There's an American author called Tom Wolfe. He's the master of if he wants to parody, if he wants to exaggerate, if he wants to, he takes you on a magic carpet ride with words. And there are very many others. There are quite a number of others. And those are the people who have influenced the way I would like to write. I like R&B. My favorite, of course, in that genre, is Lionel Richie and the Commodores. I don't think I can. I'm in a position right now to sing, but my favorite line there would be the last part of the chorus in is it the bridge or the chorus in Stockholm? Because this time, little darling, I'm coming home to stay. I'm stuck on you. I don't know why I like it. The way it just goes, there's something poetic about it. Very artistic. Yeah. I think it's a compromise. Ladies and gentlemen, it's very formal. You wouldn't say that if you're speaking to your family, right? And the President Kenyatta's idea, and I really like it, is that we're a national family. He sees us, everybody, as a national family. We are brothers, sisters, elders. So most of the time, actually, you heard him all the time saying Ndugu Zanguni. But you know, how do you bring that Ndugu Zanguni into a speech, for example, in English? You know? You can't go home to your old man or to your cousin and say, ladies and gentlemen. Between my brothers and sisters, because you can't say that all the time. It depends on the context. So fellow Kenyans, it's close enough. There's that spirit of communion. At the same time, there's almost this formality, just to show that it's a formal occasion sometimes. So fellow Kenyans, I think it's something that has come. It's a long tradition. It's a long tradition. It's one of those things that we just have to keep on. But sometimes we try to innovate around it. Sometimes we say, you know, fellow Kenyans and friends of Kenya, to include into the family our visitors, our foreign, you know, people there. Yeah. But I think it's going to be there for a while. Yeah. Unless you have suggestions, what do you want us to say? Got this feeling down deep in my soul that I just can't lose. Guess I'm all